Welcome back to the Lions franchise. It is week five, and our Detroit Lions are in New England this week to face the New England Patriots. DJ Chark had a great game last week. It's going to be hard for him to find looks this week, though, in the rain. Both teams are going to be focusing on running the football. We know what the Patriots like to do. And both teams' defenses struggle with defending the run. The Patriots are the 27th worst run defense in the league. Whereas the Lions, well, we rank dead last. So it's going to be a lot of Damian Williams, Ramondre Stevenson, DeAndre Swift, and Jamal Williams in this one. It is week five, and we are underway as the Patriots kick it off, and Khalif Raymond is there to return it. And he'll take this past the 20, past the 25, and finish at about the 26-yard line. Out come this Detroit Lions offense, led by Jared Goff. And I'd say Goff has played fine the past few weeks. Of course, his week one still lingers in those stats. But I think he's been fine so far. First down and 10-yard lines, of course, start at the 26-yard line. Man in motion. And they're going to hand it off to DeAndre Swift, who finds a lane eventually. And DeAndre Swift is past the first down marker. And it's pushed out of bounds at the 46-yard line, a 20-yard run, and a great start for this Lions offense in DeAndre Swift. It looked like he got stuffed for a second, was able to calm down, find the lane, and a big-time run. Great way to start the game. First down and 10 out the 46-yard line. Mercedes Lewis in motion now. Clock running down at 4 seconds now. 2 seconds, they hand it off, and DeAndre Swift will be met down by number 91 after pick up of 3 yards. Swift only had 53 yards rushing last week. Of course, to win this game, we need him to go off. But it's third down and 4, they're going to pass now. Goff his first drop back, he'll pass, and a weird incompletion. This is going to be fourth down as Josh Reynolds, I don't know if he wasn't ready for this football or not. Let's take a second look at this one. Clean pocket. Goff has time. Reynolds is open, but he just doesn't even try. Doesn't even attempt to go for the football. Lions stay on the field, though. It's fourth down and 4. Another ballsy call by Coach Campbell. Let's see if it pays off. Goff has a man underneath. That's Amon-Ra St. Brown, and St. Brown picks up a first down. Good start for the Lions. They convert on fourth down, and they are in Patriot territory. It's first down and 10. Goff audibly here. Again, the clock runs down. Goff is supposed to be a quick throw, and he can't find a man, and he's sacked down by Christian Barmore. Great time play by Barmore, who just kind of leaps past Frank Ragnow. I don't even know how he got past there, but he did. It is what it is, and that's a big sack for the Patriots. Second down and 15, now handoff to DeAndre Swift, who looked like he had a big lane there instead. Picks up a solid game, but it's third down and 8. This offense does not want to be in third and longs, especially in this rain. Goff has a clean pocket, though. Has a man open, and he drops it. Josh Reynolds first, can't convert a third down when he's wide open, and now drops a pass. Sure, it's behind, but you got to make that play. Fourth down and 8. 13 mile an hour winds. They're going to try for this field goal here. This is a long field goal for Cyber. Can he make it? It hits off the crossbar. It's no good. The Patriots catch a break. The Lions, what looked like a promising drive, end with 0 points. Missed the field goal, and the Pats are on the field at the 45-yard line. Hand up to Damian Harris, and he loses a yard. Now it's third and 7. Patriots in danger, going 3 and out here, and the sack is coming. It's Alex Anzalone, sent on the blitz, and eventually he gets free and gets home on Mac Jones. Great defense by the Detroit Lions, forcing the 3 and out, and the Lions offense back on the field here. First down and 10. Now Goff audibly sees something he likes. Only one safety deep for the Patriots. It's dangerous with DJ Chark on the outside. And that's where Goff is going. DJ Chark one-on-one. And great coverage by the Patriots. They were all over that one. Second down and 10 now, still at the 29-yard line. This is a handoff to DeAndre Swift, who somehow finds a lane, squeezes right through, and picks up a first down. Great play by DeAndre Swift. He is the guy this week. First and 10 now, another handoff. DeAndre Swift breaks two tackles, and oh, he couldn't break the third guy, but he still picks up 7 yards. Solid game. Third down and 2 now, and the Patriots are all over that. Not falling for the run a third time. That was Kyle Duggar, one of my favorite players in the league. Great players make great plays. This is a pass to Devontae Parker. What a stiff arm. And he'll pick up first down yardage and plenty more after that, down to the 32 of the Detroit Lions. Let's take another look at this stiff arm. That's Mike Hughes. He just says, nah, bro, get off of me. Second down and 10, handoff Damian Harris right up the gut. Big time run, down to the 13 as this first quarter is going to end with the Patriots in the red zone. Second down and 9 now, at the 13-yard line. This is a handoff to Damian Harris. He finds the lane. Damian Harris nearly broke that one off. Great tackle made by Sean Elliott. Third down and 3 now. Mac Jones has time, looking for somebody, and he'll just sail this out of bounds. And the field goal unit will come out for the pass. 3-0 now, Patriots on top. 9 minutes left in the second quarter. Goff fakes the handoff, has time, throws downfield, and what an adjustment by Amon-Ra St. Brown to get the first down. He's hyped for that one. That's a great catch by Amon-Ra in New England territory. Second down and 8 now for the Lions. Jared Goff is going to drop back pass. He's going downfield. DJ Chark, he's got a step, and it's a touchdown. DJ Chark beats the man this time for 6. This man is a year removed from a torn ACL, and he is going to get paid a lot of money with the way he's beating corners this season. Goff throws it beautifully down the left sidelines, and DJ Chark, what a grab, man. Yo, this dude is so much fun to watch. Look at that shot. What a beautiful shot that is. In New England, in the rain. Beats number 27. Beautiful, beautiful play. Patriots offense back on the field now. This is Hunter Henry on 3rd down and 8. Avoiding a 3-and-out by the Patriots. That's a good catch and a good first down. 5 minutes approaching in the second quarter. 3rd down and 12. Another 3rd down here. Mac Jones blitzes picked up, but Damian Harris lets it go. It's Mike Hughes on the sack. And it's a 4th down and 20. Of course, they're not going to go for this. And the Lions are in the driver's seat now. Second down and 10 out for the Lions. 4 minutes left. There's a pass to TJ Hockenson, and he'll get a first down pretty easily. Moving on now, though, is 3rd down and 8 on their own 42-yard line. You want to convert this here. With the 2-minute warning approaching, you got to get some points before halftime if you're the Lions. Goff has a clean pocket, has a man wide open. Hockenson, and he drops it. I get that it's raining. I get the elements are in effect here, but, man, when you beat the man, when you're wide open and the ball hits you in the hands, you have to make that catch. Point blank, period. 1st down and 10, Patriots on the field. What a grab! Hunter Henry. This could be a Hunter Henry game for the Patriots. As did he get his feet in bounds? I don't know if he did, but with less than 2 minutes left, we can't challenge that. And another conversion. It's 3rd down, complete to Hunter Henry. He'll pick up a first down. A minute 15 now. Who else? Hunter Henry through the middle. Another first down. This is his drive. 2nd down and 7, less than a minute left. Another quick pass to Hunter Henry. This man is making all the plays right now on this drive. 3rd down and 1, though, he wasn't able to pick up a first down. 50 seconds left. Mac Jones throws downfield for Hunter Henry and overshot it. Otherwise, this is a big first down, and the Lions get away with one there. Lions back on offense. It's a downfield pass to Josh Reynolds. And a first down. Approaching midfield, 35 seconds left. They do still have two timeouts. Goff has time, throws downfield, and he's intercepted. Intercepted by Devin McCourty. Future Hall of Famer makes a great play, although I think TJ Hockenson. I guess Hockenson didn't even see him because he was expecting to just keep running in stride. Instead, McCourty, let's take a look at this, just jumps the route. If Hockenson is a little more aware, maybe he boxes him out, tries to make the catch, but I don't know, man. You see Amon-Ra on the right sideline, wide open. Safety was looking at Hock the whole time. That hurts. Second down and 10 now. Devontae Parker, big time run, jukes out a man, and is pushed out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Clock is still going, though. Patriots are going to call timeout with 6 seconds left and try for a deep field goal. This is a 60-yard field goal, and it's got no shot. Field goal completely misses. Patriots don't get points before halftime, although there's a second left. And it looks like the Lions offense is going to stay on the field here. Are you kidding me? There's no way he makes that catch. Hail Mary before halftime. His second touchdown grab of the half. Can we take a look at this again? I need to see this again. First off, great job by Goff stepping up in the pocket. Getting the football down there in the first place. Hold on here. Four Patriot defenders all run into each other and Chark is right behind them. Are you kidding me? Right behind the ball, perfectly over the defenders into Chark's hands. That's incredible. That is incredible. But now, did he score? Like, did the ball cross the plane? I mean, I don't know if we can say whether it did or didn't, but they ruled it a touchdown initially, and they're not going to overturn it. There's no clear evidence to say he didn't score that, so it's a touchdown. And the Lions somehow go up 14-6 at the half. Patriots get the ball, though, at second down and 9, and Mac Jones opens up the half with a nice strike to Devontae Parker for a first down. Second down and 3 now, I formation. Two tight ends set. It's a handoff to the outside, and Damian Harris breaks a tackle, jukes out a man, and goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line. A nice run for Damian Harris. He's got to be the guy for the Patriots. And here he goes again, up the gut, breaks a tackle, first down. He's got to be the guy if the Patriots want to win this football game. Moving on now, though, it's a third down and 10. Mac Jones throws a dangerous pass, but somehow complete. That's Ramondre Stevenson out of the backfield. I don't know how he completed that pass. First and goal now. This is a great drive to open up the second half for the Pats. Mac Jones has time. Wide open touchdown. Devontae Parker. Coming out of the half with a phenomenal drive are the Patriots. And they score the first touchdown of the game. Devontae Parker's had two big catches. Now he catches a touchdown. And of course, going for the two-point conversion. It's a handoff to Damian Harris, and four Lions in the backfield, not falling for it. And the Detroit Lions still have the lead, 14-12. Offense back on the field now. It's first down and 10. The 30-yard line, they're going to hand it off to DeAndre Swift, who picks up a couple blocks. And close to a first down marker, they'll say inches. Handoff to Jamal Williams, and he'll pick up a first down. Now, Jonah Jackson seems to be shaken up. One of the best offensive linemen on the Lions. That could prove to be a big injury later on in the game. But for now, DeAndre Swift has a lane. Gets a first down, gets a block. And DeAndre Swift is in the open field. Caught from behind. Oh, I thought he was gone.
down at the 18-yard line. I thought Swift was gone when he picked up that block. That was Amonra, I think. Amazing block. Oh, I wish he was gone. Now it's a third down and 5. Lions in danger of squandering this opportunity. Goff's rolling to his right. Finds Swift underneath, but I don't think he can get the first down, and he can't. Fourth and 2 after that big DeAndre Swift run. That hurts to see. We know Coach Campbell is aggressive, but to make this more, you know, to force the Patriots to need a touchdown here, I think that would be the right call, but it looks like the offense is going to stay out there. They just need 2 yards. They're at the 10-yard line. And they're lining up 5 wide here. Clock rolling down, though. I don't know if they're actually going to snap it. This looks like just trying to draw them off sides. That is the case. So they'll just settle for 3. And the score is 17-12. Pats on the field now. Mac Jones throws a dangerous pass. That could have been picked 6th.
Ineligible receiver downfield.
Ineligible man downfield. And they're moving backwards. 2nd and 14 for the Pats at their own 21. Mac Jones has a man wide open and he dropped it. Devontae Parker's had a great game so far. Drops a big one right there. Now it's 3rd and 14. Mac Jones has time. Nobody open though. Mac Jones has all day though, and eventually throws downfield to Hunter Henry, and he drops it. Back-to-back big drops. And the Lions offense takes the field, and now back on 3rd and 9. The Lions have to go 3 and out as well. Jared Goff had a wide open DeAndre Swift. And Kyle Duggar, we mentioned him earlier, makes a massive play. This could have been a touchdown. Look at the field ahead of DeAndre Swift. Kyle Duggar makes a potential touchdown-saving hit on Jared Goff. That hurts. Patriots back on the field now. It's 2nd down and 8. Mac Jones under center is going to run, hit backwards, and get sacked. Julian Okwara and Aiden Hutchinson both there for the sack. You love to see it. And it's 3rd down and 20 as the fourth quarter begins. Mac Jones has time, but he'll just throw short. And that'll be another 3 and out for the Patriots. Lions back on offense. Have to get some points here and end this game. DeAndre Swift has a hole. DeAndre Swift caught from behind again. I don't know if he's injured or what, but just doesn't have the breakaway speed that we're used to seeing from DeAndre Swift in this one. Could be the elements as well. That turf, that ground, could be hard to find your footing. 3rd down and 3 though for the Lions, and Goff finds Swift underneath. Big conversion as they're trying to get some points here. 1st down and 10. Swift is decimated down, and now TJ Hockenson is hurt. No. One of our best pass catchers, our only pass catching tight end on the roster, is injured heading to the back. That's not a good sign. 2nd down and 10. Now Goff underneath, and Amonra drops it. They're saying a rib injury for TJ Hockenson. He will not return for this game. It's 3rd down and 10. Now they go a end around reverse, and that fools nobody. And instead of gaining some extra yards to kick a long field goal, they lose a bunch of yardage and have to punt the football. Patriots back on offense. It's 3rd down and 4, and Mac Jones finds Jonnu Smith. Haven't said his name too much, but he catches a first down right there. It's another 3rd down, though. Lions have to get off the field here. It's 3rd down and 5, 4 minutes remaining. Wide open man, Jonnu Smith again. First down. Mac Jones has played a relatively clean game so far. It's 1st down and 10. Their own 39-yard line. The Patriots need a touchdown here. Another short pass. This is Nelson Aguilar. Haven't heard his name called as much either. But he'll get a first down right here. Coach Campbell is scared on the sidelines here. It's first down and 10. Bliss coming. Bliss picked up nicely. Mask gonna throw downfield. One-on-one coverage. It's caught. Devontae Parker skies over Amani Oruwariye. And he's down at the one. Are you kidding me? What the Lions did not need. Amani just, was he not ready for it? He never saw the ball coming. Didn't even try to jump. And the Pats are first and goal now. Second and goal. They play fake. Mac Jones has Jonnu Smith for the touchdown. Oh my God. What just happened? The Lions have been up the entire game. What is happening right now? 2-point conversion try for the Pats. Nobody open. Mac's gonna roll to his right and dump off to Aguilar, and he cannot cross the plane. It is still a 1-point game. At least there's that. But holy moly, how are the Lions losing this game right now? 2.5 minutes left. They do still have 3 timeouts. Come on, Lions. Come on, Lions. You cannot lose this game. Goff, hands off. DeAndre Swift has a lane. He runs past the first down marker and also be stopped around the 40-yard line. That's a good start for the drive as we essentially go to the 2-minute warning. First down and 10 now. Goff, hands off. DeAndre Swift, this time the Pats are all over it. Only a 2-yard gain. It's second and 8. The clock is continuing to wind down. 1:40 left in this game at their own 41-yard line. Let's see what the Lions can do. Goff has a clean pocket. Throws underneath. Josh Reynolds drops the ball. 3rd and 8. The elements are playing against the Lions right now. With 1.5 minutes left. Lions got to do something here, man. This is a big 3rd down play here. I'm nervous. They set up trips right. DeAndre Swift on the left to Jared Goff. Josh Reynolds is the one man on the outside. It's 3rd down and 8. Goff, quick pass. And it's another drop. No way. This time it's DJ Chark of all people dropping the ball. And it's 4th down now. This crowd is going crazy. It's 4th and 8 at their own 41. Less than 1.5 minutes in the game. What are the Lions going to do here? Obviously, they have to go for it. Obviously, they have to pass the ball. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Clock is winding down as well. Play clock down to 6, 5, 4. Goff finds Chark, and he holds on. First down. Timeout, Detroit. Big first down conversion. Goff to Chark. Who else is Goff going to trust in that situation? 1st down and 10. Goff underneath. DeAndre Swift makes the grab out of the backfield down to the 39-yard line. It's 2nd down and 3. Less than 1 minute left in the game now. They're going to hand off. Swift has a lane rather wide open up the gut. And now the Patriots are going to call timeout. 1st down and 10, Swift. Oh my gosh, I thought he was gone. I saw the hole for a split second and thought he was gone. Only a 3-yard gain now. Now Goff gonna audible out of this. Less than 8 seconds on the play clock now. 2nd and 7, handoff to Swift. Up the gut, and he'll pick up a couple yards. Now it's 3rd down and 3. It's a big 3rd down here. Swift in motion. 3rd down and 3. What do the Lions got here? 45 seconds left in the game. They do still have 2 timeouts. Goff, immediate pressure, and he's sacked. No. Dietrich Wise gets through clean immediately. How does that happen? And now the Lions rush their field goal unit out. They're not going to call timeout. Patriots have no timeouts left. They're just going to let the clock wind down, I guess. It's 4th down and 10. This is a, 59-yard field goal try in the elements, and he missed it! No way! Lions missed the field goal. What is happening? What just happened? I don't know what happened. A second left. Oh. I don't know what happened. The Lions were up 17-12. Virtually the entire game, up 14-6, up 7-3, and they lose the game. Unbelievable. 18-17 is the final score of the Patriots. Come from behind, win at home. As you see Mac and Goff dap it up. Oh my God. This was a game we could not lose, should not have lost, and we lost anyway. I cannot believe this. Goff played a solid game. I mean, a lot of those incompletions were drops. The elements played a big role in this game. A lot of drops, two missed field goals by the Lions. DeAndre Swift, man. It sucks that we wasted a game like that from DeAndre Swift. 145 rushing yards. Hunter Henry was a menace on the drive. On one drive, Devontae Parker got that big Hail Mary, essentially catch down at the one. DJ Chark played a hell of a game. Two touchdowns, including the Hail Mary at the end. Oh my gosh. I can't believe we lost that game. This was the sack that essentially pushed us out of field goal range where our left guard, we lost Jonah Jackson earlier in the game, the backup Logan Stenberg, lets the interior pressure come through immediately and goes for the blitzing linebacker. That's offensive line 101, what you're not supposed to do. You always go for the immediate pressure, guys. That is a tough way to go out, man. Immediate questions come, calling for the conditions being the reason why the Lions lost, and of course, Coach Campbell. Not want to make excuses. Just saying the Patriots were a better team, man. And, oof. That hurts. That loss hurts. Meanwhile, in the division, the Vikings beat the Chicago Bears in what was a turnover-filled, high-scoring contest. Dalvin Cook, of course, is the engine of the offense. And the Vikings stay undefeated. Wow, man, that loss sucks. That loss really sucks. We enter the bye week at 1-4, last in the division. But that's the video, guys. Appreciate the love, appreciate the support. Make sure you comment down below. Make sure you like the video, please do. We'll play the Cowboys in week 7. That's a game that we need to win. Most of these games coming up, we need to win. But that's the video, guys. Appreciate the love, appreciate the support. And see you on the next one. Peace.